Good morning, students. Today I am going to cover only the structure of class and object. Class is a user defined data type, and it's a way to bind data and function together in a single unit. Here, this is class. Class is a keyword. Here, this is class. Class is a keyword, and this is class name. It means it's a name of the class, and this class is started with this curly braces and end with this semicolon. Here we are declared variable. It means that it is data member, or we can say that member data. And if we declare function inside the class, it means that it's a member function. There are three types of access specifier, which are private, public, and the next one is protected. If we declare member inside the private section, it means that it can only be accessible by within the class only. If we declare member inside the public section, it means that it can be accessible by outside the class only. Or if we declare member inside the protected section, it means that it can only be accessible by within the class as well as member of the derived class only. Already discussed these three. Points: public, private, and protected. Now, next is object. What is object? Object is nothing. It's an instance of class, or we can say that it's a variable of class. Once a class has been created, we can create variable of that class. This is the syntax for creating object. First, we write class name, then variable name. Student is the class name and S is the variable of this student class. And also we can create more than one object belonging to that class. Now this is the syntax for creating object. S1 and S2 are the object of this class name, and class is a keyword. Keyword are the words which compiler known, or we can say that it's a predefined word. Now come to accessing class member. Accessing class member means how we can access the member of the class. Here this is the method for accessing member function. Here this is syntax for accessing member function. Object name. First we write object name, then dot operator, then member function of that of particular class with arguments. It means that, for example, S is the object name and getData is the member function. GetData is the member function, and this getData is accessible with the help of only this object and this dot operator. With the help of this dot operator and object, we can only access the member function of particular class. If any data member declared in a public session, then we can also access this data member also. Defining member function. Defining member function means there are two types of there are two methods by which we can define the member function. First one is inside the class definition, and the second one is outside the class definition. Inside the class definition means how we can define the member of class inside. This is the syntax for defining. This is the syntax for defining member function inside the class. Get data is the member function, and here getData is the member function and putData is also a member function. Here we are defining getData function by inputting two values, num and cost. And here we are displaying two values, num and cost, with the help of this putData function. Outside the class definition means how we can define the member of class from outside the class. This is the syntax for defining member function outside the class. Return type, class name, function name with arguments. This is colon. Colon means it tells the compiler that this function name belong to this class name, and its type is void, int, whatever. And this is the function body where we can write any statement. And this is the syntax for defining the member function and putData function from outside the class. Here we are using scope resolution operator, and this is void type. GetData belongs to void type, and it belongs to item class. It means that scope resolution operator tells the compiler that this getData function belongs to this item class, and its type is void. Thank you, friends. We will meet again in next topic.